And wonders when faith is renewed and we gather to remember the birth of Jesus, the light of the world. This is a season of dazzling miracles and glorious marvels, a treasured time that renews and restores our broken hopes and dreams. It is a season for worship, a time to seek and find, a shining moment of music and celebration. Yes, this is the season of light and hope. Let us rejoice and be glad. Hear the word of the Lord. Arise, shine, your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you.
Thank you. This is the season of light and peace. From generation to generation, we have longed for our promised Redeemer. When will our prayers be answered? When will the shadows surrender and our sorrows cease? The sands of time have not covered our dreams for peace and joy. Deep in the hearts of the people, there shines a spark of divine hope. As a great light kindled by faith flickers with expectation, then soon the morning star will appear and bathe the world with golden grace. We remember the word of the prophets. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those in the land of deep darkness, the light has dawned.
Thank you.
With mystery and majesty, the angel Gabriel declares the miracle that will change the world forever. Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you. Mary, you will conceive a child and give birth to a son. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign forever, and his kingdom will never end. With this angelic acclamation, divine joy pours into a sad, weary world and begins a song that will echo through eternity. Jesus is coming soon. Rejoice, give thanks, and sing.
This is the season of light and love. As we gather in this place of devotion and worship, we pause to remember the story of Christ's birth. Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph. Before they came together, she was found to be pregnant from the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name of Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
Thank you.
the season of light and glory. In the fields outside of Bethlehem, there were shepherds who were watching over their flocks of sheep in the cool of the evening. Without warning, an angel clothed in the glory of heaven appeared to them. Alarmed at such a greeting, the angel said, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you glad tidings of great joy, which will be for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace and goodwill to all people." Beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was dark and empty. Darkness was over the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering above the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. From the Gospel of John, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of the world. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it."